First day using the new Ultra HD foundation. I ran out of my Invisible Cover HD, whatever they used to make, and that I used to wear in pink porcelain. I think it was shade 110. It always felt a little too pink, so this time I opted for marble, which is like 117 Y225, so you'll see the results in a little bit. Whoa, just realized that this Makeup Forever HD foundation that my mom had bought for herself and then didn't like and gave me is actually the 117 color. So I might try to test this out too. I remember thinking it was terrible on me, but let's see. I mean, this one's the equivalent of the color I just bought and I like it.
I like this foundation. I don't like wet hair. Why does hair have to be such like a multiple hour long process? I'm just gonna put it in a bun wet because
I live for little kids in safety vests walking in lines. It's so cute.
It's not a successful vlog unless there's some sort of element of car talk. So I just went to Aesop, switched out the parsley seed mask that Ryan got me, and I got the chamomile one, and then I got their little control blemish spot treatment because I don't have a spot treatment right now.
Look at this sign. Hey, that makes me want to go inside. Ooh, I got something in the mail. Midday pizza party. It's blurry, don't worry, no one can see. Oh, not focused. Ooh, that cheese trail is derish. Let's just zoom in on that cheese trail real quick. Perks of being next to the designer consignment store. Jenna just went over and grabbed this YSL number and Prada shoes for fun to try on to take a picture in the mirror. Sue Generis, everybody. Designer consignment. Go to Anna Me and then visit Miguel's shop. It is amazing. Photo shoot time.
Those are the packages behind me that USPS was supposed to pick up but fucking didn't, even though I saw them on the street and I have a scheduled pickup today. It's so frustrating when they just don't come. It's so annoying. He even has lied and been like, oh, I went and you were closed, and it's like, no, I was here till 10:30, so I was here. You didn't even try to come after hours.
Take your steam water somewhere else. I'll have a glass of steam water.
I'm gonna make it tea. We just ate a meal at some Italian place in North Beach, and it was terrible.
Disgusting.
Overpriced and not very good. Vlogging while going across a crosswalk, guaranteed death. Oh, sorry. We're going to Cobb's Comedy to go to Todd Berry's crowd work show, which I'm very excited about. And I like it also because it's Ryan's worst nightmare, potentially being talked to in a crowd by a comedian.
Yeah.
What'd you say?
Nothing.
What'd you say?
Nothing. I'm not material for yours.
We talk about
pimples.
Listen, we talk about pimples.
No, and I was at a comedy show and I could feel a pimple growing on my face at that moment.
Fucking loser.
Jerk.
You want to know what I wish we had right now?
What?
Ho-hos.
Get he was like, away.
Ho-hos?
And he goes, what? Ho-hos?
Ho-hos? I love ho-hos.
Hey, Dexter does too. Hey, Ann.
Hey, Dexter. Do you love ho-hos?
Happy 2:45 in the morning. If you don't think that I'm watching Forensic Files while eating a frozen Eggo and peanut butter out of the jar, then you've got another thing coming, because I've had two glasses of Chardonnay, so watch the fuck out. This is what happens when you don't ever drink. Your tolerance gets real low. So yeah. I love frozen Eggos. Shout me out in the comments if you love them too. So cold. Another one. I'm actually super over DJ Khalid, whatever the fuck his name is. Bless up, Kiki. I followed him for like 3 days on Snapchat and then shit got fucking old. But it was fun while it lasted, so thanks for that, bro.
When you ask Grubhub to include silverware in your order so that way you can eat it, and they don't,
You're left using this as a spoon. I'm not even kidding. I'm sitting here scooping my glazed teriyaki up with a fucking cap. I know this is like super unlikely, but fucking pray for me that like Ryan somehow doesn't have a direct ride home and he happens to walk by a corner store and can get in my ass some ho-hos. Oh yeah. Yay, I feel gross now.
Just your casual 1:30 in the morning face mask. I like this one because it kind of just looks like I'm really bad at blending foundation. It doesn't match my skin. But this is, my lips didn't get all the red out. This is the Aesop Chamomile Concentrate Anti-Blemish Mask. So this is what I picked up.
Hey guys, just watching a forensic file that happened to be about someplace in Pennsylvania. And I'm kind of really excited to see how this unfolds because the strip club that's featured in this crazy story of a suburban housewife mysteriously found drowned is the one where Ryan went.
But you're not allowed to move your mouth when you have a mask on?
You can't move your mouth because your face tightens up. Ryan just cooked me breakfast.
Blanchard denied he had touched the hole. The only person who Ben Affleck hasn't been unfaithful to.
Okay, we were like, fuck the Golden Globes, this is boring. So we're going through some of the last episodes of Forensic Files that I have yet to watch, but I really like the ones where girls get murdered and I don't like arson ones and I'm running out of options. I'm gonna go with Police Officer Kills Wife, that should be good. You guys, I'm so behind the times. I still use iMovie 8, even though I bought the purple iMovie. See, that's purple iMovie. That's the one I use. I don't like purple iMovie. It's weird, even though it is the newer version. So I stick with 8, but I'm running into some serious issues with it. It crashes. It barely lets me export. This is like the fifth time I've tried to export this freaking 7-minute video. And I have to do everything like export to QuickTime now. So I'm thinking it's time I should upgrade my ass to Final Cut Pro X. I actually have like an old version of Final Cut Pro in here, but I have no fucking clue how to use it. And it's really complicated. It's like 3 versions old. So again, archaic stuff. If you guys have any tutorial recommendations, how did you learn how to use it? Let me know, because mama needs to upgrade. New cameras, new equipment, new software. I'm doing YouTube right this time. But have no fear, I will still maintain my awful amazing editing. But it'll just be better because I'll have more options. Like, I don't know how to make something fly across the screen. Do you know how many times I want to do something like that? Do you know how long it took me to edit a fire in front of Haley's crotch in the lost footage of part 2 today? Because all I could do was copy and paste an emoji into text and then do all these spaces and stuff to make it fit in the right spot. It was hard. I need help. You know what I just realized? I'm gonna have to cancel this exportation of this project and I'm gonna have to add this in because it's Sunday when I'm doing this. And if anything, I'm really anal about sticking to the days. Ugh, more work.